Did you know you could use Microsoft Edge as a PDF editor? That's what I want to show you today on Teachers Tech. Hi, I'm Jamie, and it's great to have you here. So I have this PDF on my desktop, and I'm going to go ahead and open it with Microsoft Edge. Now, that's not my default PDF editor right now, but you could change it if you wanted to make that your editor. I'm going to right-click and go Open With, and we're going to go to Microsoft Edge. As soon as I open this up, I get all these different tools across the top, and there's going to be a few more. Even if I right click on it, I have all these options. Now, I just want to start with, I'm going to zoom up a little bit. I can go to fit to width here, and I'm going to show you this option. So if you want this read aloud, if I go ahead and click this.
Microsoft Word tutorial. Here is the best Microsoft.
So I'm going to go ahead and stop that. It will start reading it from the top. So if I go to voice options, if I don't want this voice, I can drop down, I can speed it up, and I can choose a voice. So you can customize it that way. I'm going to close out of this. I do want to show you if all of a sudden, if you don't want to have it read from the beginning, what you can do. If I go ahead and just highlight this and click in here, take a look at this. So I can go ahead and have this read aloud from here. So now if I go,
click it again to unpin the item at any time.
So you don't have to start at the beginning. Okay, so I'm going to close out of the voice options, and I want to show you a few other things. I can add text very quickly. So if I click on this, I can click and I can start typing away. So type what you want. We can change our color to these ones. We can increase the size. We can move this in different ways. So very easy to add more text. If you find something is missing, you can see we can delete it. We can also use the pen tool. So if I select that drop down, and you can see where you can choose your colors, choose how thick you want, and then you can go through and start marking up this way to pull out all the important information for you through here. But not only a pen, we do have a highlighter that you can go through and do the exact same thing. And we can change our colors and thickness on this as well. So very easily start to mark this up. Anything you want gone, just use the eraser and scratch that out, and you can see how quickly things disappear. So it doesn't work on the text, just on the pen and the highlighter. Here's a few more cool features this can do. So if I was going to go ahead and highlight a word, and I get these options right through here, you can see I can copy, search, define, and I can do the highlighting from here. I can add a comment also. So I could put a comment to these. You can see I have a few more options to edit or delete it afterwards, but I could just hit the check mark and then I have it. So I could go back, click on this, I could add more comments after. So it's a nice way to add, if you're working, someone's sharing with you a PDF, you can open it up here and quickly add those comments. Now I can use this also to look up words. So if I was going to go through here, I could define, it's going to just give me a definition of this, or I could actually look up, use the web. If I go ahead and do a search for this again, so I'm just going to highlight this, make sure I get exactly what I want. I'll just highlight. And then if I do a search, it will go on the web and look for it. So a few neat options there. The other thing what I like that it can do is that you can do a screenshot from this. So if I go ahead and I'm just going to right click and I'm going to do a web capture and just choose that. And let's say if there was an image in here that I wanted, maybe it's all marked up. I could go ahead, select it, and I could mark up the capture, visual search from here. But let's say I'm going to go to markup. I could go here and then I could draw over it. And at this option here, I can share it out. I could save this separately from the PDF. So another good option that you can quickly use inside Microsoft Edge as a PDF editor. So I'm going to go ahead and just close this. I'm not worrying about saving this. But if you do want to save everything, we have our save options right here where you can go the save as, and then all your markups, all your notes and comments will be saved when you save it to your computer. If you don't want to save it, just go ahead and print it and it will have all the markups and notes that you've put on it as well. All right, so I hope you like this little walkthrough, quick walkthrough of how to use Microsoft Edge as a PDF editor. A lot of people have overlooked this feature in it, but it's a great one if you don't want to go ahead and purchase anything and you just want to make those quick markups on a PDF. Let me know what you think of this. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.